I am going to answer some questions that are on these floppy cards. The questions that I select have been heavily vetted by my team of entertainment experts so that they will be the most entertaining things you've ever heard. Have you, or would you ever, do a Broadway play? I have never, but I would never say never. Who are your all-time favorite Hollywood actor or actresses? Ooh, gosh, well, that's pretty fun. You know, old school, I love the classics. You know, the elegant Cary Grant and Grace Kelly. Did you ever turn down a role only to regret it later? No, because I don't think I've ever turned down a role. If you hadn't become an actor, what would your profession have been? Thief. If you could have dinner with any person living or dead, who would that be? Well, if it were living, dead, or fictional, it would be the Keebler Cookie Man, and I'd ask him, how do you make all those cookies in that tiny little tree? What was your best and worst subject in high school? Latin. I loved, but I was terrible at it, and I think I failed, but they passed me just to get me the hell out of the school. What is your ideal meal? I like oysters with all the stuff, and then give me some vodka on the rocks with the oyster. This is, you know, obviously not gonna be able to eat like this forever, but the ideal meal is in a perfect universe where you don't have to worry about your blood pressure or, you know, impending death or the bill. I would like to have some caviar on the side with those oysters, and then I'm gonna go straight in for just like a crazy prime rib, bottle of French wine, maybe some French fries. Pommes frites. When did you know you wanted to become an actor? Well, when I was about 13, I used to ride my bike around town with a little Panasonic tape player in the rat trap on the back of my 10-speed, my Panasonic 10-speed. And I wore sunglasses and all black. And I would listen to the Rolling Stones Emotional Rescue playing from the back of the thing. I will come to you. And my father got a load of this and he said, Hollywood. And he didn't mean that in a nice way. In Connecticut, calling somebody Hollywood is an insult. So pretty early on, I think it was in the DNA. Again, not necessarily a good thing. You don't become an actor because things went well growing up, right? You're pre-damaged. It's a self-selected set of circumstances that put you in a position where you would rather be somebody else all day long. What's your favorite thing about living and working in New York? What's your least favorite? My favorite thing about living and working in New York is that this is where I was born, so it's in my blood, it's very familiar to me, and I'm a New Yorker. My least favorite thing is, you know, I think it's very complicated to walk around with small children and explain why, you know, people are sleeping on the street and why people have, but at the same time, it's important for them to understand that they're very fortunate and that we do have to have some responsibility for the other people we share the planet with. What's your all-time favorite movie? It changes. Right now, it's My Favorite Year, Peter O'Toole. I'm not an actor, I'm a movie star. If you could live anywhere in the world, where would it be? What? Right here. I like New York City, I like living here. I mean, yes, the south of France is very nice. I like Jamaica, but if you gotta live in a place for a period of time, I like New York. What's the weirdest request you've gotten from a fan? The foot massage. Do you have a morning routine? Do I have a morning routine? Was Liberace straight? Who was your childhood celebrity crush? Jessica Lange and King Kong. I was 8 years old when I saw that monkey movie. My God. Faye Ray in the Hands of Kong is one thing, but Jessica Lange.